Archangel Simon's assistance, tons of temple activations, helpful light clusters, and even better timeline. The day is 144 hours and starts at 3 p.m. after hitting the 3 a.m. meditation bells 6 times prior. This post's launch time is the East Coast USA 808 morning gate. On the 3D date 010321, the following 3 p.m. will start this new day. Follow this parallel around the globe until it hits local time at 3 p.m. If you are conscious that a new day has begun, it is customary to send love and kindness to someone. Archangelic calendar is infinity 21A7 infinity infinity A6E6E6A6E6E6 infinity infinity Q6060633 infinity infinity B2TT infinity. Please visit us at archangelickcalendar.com for more information. And please do not forget to like, comment, share and subscribe. Thank you for your continued support. The calendar. Gaia is in Circe's will, Circe our galaxy, acts upon the infinite universe's will. The current setting element, galactic breeze, is a macro, air settings. The setting is like a breath of fresh air in a very literal and cosmic sense. The cosmic energies coming in are new, wonderful, and soul-quenching. The major mistake timekeepers make by resetting the clock is that every day is new. How can we use a revolving calendar? Even if we wish to see the Earth's rotation is circular, it does not account for the changes in cosmic position. Even from an astrophysics perspective, each day is in a completely new energy field, and thus, going backward is not possible. The statement may seem like a little sentiment until we realize how we perceive time is extremely relevant to our life experience. For sure, we had a blast of energy originating from the Sun during the Saturn-Jupiter solstice conjunction. This energy is profound and powerful. The energy from the Sun feeds us in every way imaginable. The Sun's energy directly funds everything from the apple you eat to your body movements. We enhanced these efforts in the assignments a few days back. All parties involved are genuinely grateful for the help. None of us was upset about the energy of the previous timeline. Nevertheless, gigantic timeline jumps have brought us from great to even better. We did not consciously initiate such motions, but our macro self is ready to give us way more than we ask. The macro can think much further out than our human perspectives. When working on manifestations, it always has the final say. Missing segments of time can happen quicker than a flash, but they may be hiding an unimaginable amount of time therein. To help digest what this is like, it would be like being zapped to another reality and staying there for many years only to return to the former moment like nothing ever happened. You still get to keep the wisdom and knowledge gained by the experience but not the direct memory. There is no way of knowing just how much time we are experiencing without our cognition. Philosophical buffet. Schrödinger's cat is a pivotal experiment that, regardless of its morality, helps explain the quantum nature of the universe. The investigation put a cat in a box with poison and a radioactive source. They used a Geiger counter to figure out when the cat passes before opening the package. They found the cat was in both states of dead and alive until observation made a definitive choice. The human in myself says that any organic matter would have served this experiment the same, and there was no need to do this to sentient life. Regardless, it laid the foundation of modern quantum physics. They concluded that the universe stays in a state of possibilities until observation chooses a pathway to physicality. Don't be excited about tomorrow, be excited about today. There is no evidence tomorrow even exists, it's always today as soon as we get there. Please stay in the now, savor the moment, smell the flowers, and feel the moment as it is. Change is gradual, much like healing. Walking day by day towards expansion is the nature of the universe. Flowers grow with constant grace and ease. At our best, we develop the same way. The cosmic natural has explosive expansions but only on a macro scale that originates from the earth. Many people report dreams where someone is speaking, they can't hear them, but they fully understand. Most of the time, this is an archangel, but it can apply to any form of communication from any telepathic source. The wisest ancients describe telepathy as understanding, not a mental verbal conversation. It is helpful to discover the difference between hearing, listening, and learning. We all speak energy, and this is the actual Rosetta Stone. We feel the sentiment and allow our minds to interpret it. Most of the time, you can understand a person just by observing an expression on their face. It's very similar, only on a less physical scale. If there is something you want, impulses will try to deter you. This describes the same situation described by the indigenous as real vs fake body, or others describe it as the devil tempting you. Let's say you wish to be an astronaut. Without utter conviction, the lesser impulses will offer you temporary highs as a consolation prize to your goal. So instead of studying for that exam, you may binge play video games or oversleep. Success is in the many small things we do correctly and is not one big moment of glory. Legion hodgepodge. Archangel Simon is one of the most practical archangels of all time. Simon understands humanity in deep and profound ways. He is an excellent archangel to call when you need order in your life. A good cleaning buddy of all things large and small. We ask everyone to evoke Simon to help us straighten out any entanglement we have with other timelines. The indigenous ancestors ask us to answer their call, listen deeply to what they are saying. Poisoning the food supply will stimulate the hand that feeds law. Food-related illness is the most efficient killer on earth. This poisoning effort works by the perversion of natural foods and extremely harmful hidden chemicals. According to many, many reports from many different sources, the Anunnaki are in intense negotiations with a certain Draco clan. What is meant by intense talks is they, Anunnaki, threatening to remove this clan from existence. We would have front row seats for this conflict if it weren't that we align ourselves with our ancestors in this situation. The specific group of antagonists is a Draco minority group that is not confused with the entire race. This particular group will appear multiple times in this report. Helpful light clusters are a flock of light orbs that are extremely helpful and loving. They remind us of galactic fairies but in a much more energetic way. If you see a cluster in the ether, they are lovely. Many reports of tall whites have been flooding the community. These are friendly people. All personalities are people no matter what form they take. An individualized character and commitment to preserving the sanctity of its own life is the only requiring factor of sentiency. An individual, malevolent star race can augment someone's reality with quantum manipulation. This tool is a technology available to all beings as portal work has become commonplace. We have seen this tool work benevolent and malevolent. This technology caused Abraham to hear evil voices and is now rubble thanks to the Queen of the Dragons, her and her Life Form Collective, and Archangel Metatron Collective, he and his Life Form Collective. An enormous amount of things are about to be disclosed to humanity. Today's tools. Tools will be active until the next post. Use the legend below to help you decipher how to best use today's weapons. Passive equals no intention needed to use or arm. It will work on its own when you accept its presence. All you need to do is give permission, and it will work on your behalf. Active equals intention needed to use. Aggressive equals will attack before anything has a chance to harm you. Do not try to wield weapons if there is no pure love in your heart for your emotions and the attached beings. General, we have a strong shield and armor set. Archangel Metatron's broadsword is still in play. It is only said this way as a precaution. Leave nothing to chance in our control. The violet flame is set for 9:27 to 2 plus 7 equals 9. The violet flame is in its correct violet setting, which evokes a transmutational quickening. This fire is a very concentrated flame with unlimited omnipotence. The violet flame team is as follows and is in no particular order: Archangel Jezreel, Archangel Galizur, Archangel Ednachil, Archangel Emmanuel, Archangel Serviel, Archangel Michdeel, Archangel Bazazath, Archangel Tubiel, Archangel Dequiel, Archangel Saniel, Archangel Beriel, Archangel Zadquiel, Archangel Omiel, Archangel Zadekiel, Archangel Peliel, Archangel Fanuel, Archangel Germain, Archangel Ansiel, Archangel Sablo, Archangel Briathos, Archangel Harahel, Archangel Eshma, Archangel Issa, Archangel Af, Archangel Tatrasil, Archangel Abraxos, Archangel Adonai, Archangel Shimsiel, Archangel Vermiel, and Archangel Dabriel. active. Archangel Michael's legendary sword can handle anything, as it is entirely omnipotent. No level of consciousness can block this divine weapon. It is also a great weapon against electronics and technology, as it can override any circuitry. Passive, active and aggressive. Archangel Isaac's radiant field looks a lot like Magneto's force field, and it reacts to any life form with either loving energy or a transmutational blast of vast power. Passive and aggressive. Archangel Leo's Swords of Plenty is a passive and aggressive attack sword with a complete will. Do not try to wield at all, you will only get in the way. Equip and go. Passive and aggressive. Archangel Shepherd's Orb is a divinity presence that allows anyone to encounter a clear path to forgiveness or a direct audience with infinitely expanding creator source. This tool is a genuinely compassionate tool of divine orchestration. Passive. Archangel Zedekiel's Pendant of Justice lessens all judgment against you and casts you in a favorable light. This tool is also useful for general shielding. Active. Archangel Zagzagel's Staff Heavenly Might rains large crystal masses upon a targeted area. Great for large targets, works on the physical and non-physical as well. Active and passive. Archangel Dabil's Staff of Bear Medicine can heal all natural things. The staff is also a powerful ally against all items that may obstruct you. Active and passive. Archangel Chaliel's Horn summons an army of unimaginable power to your location. This horn is a hypersensitive tool, and it will adapt to current events in your life and on a global scale. Passive. Archangel Orphamil's Charm of Divine Permission permits the divine hand of infinitely expanding creator source to intervene in your life directly. Active and passive. Archangel Yehudia's Wand of Structure can build a stairway to heaven or any other metaphysical form to perfection. This tool is helpful in building force fields of protection as well. Passive. Archangel Jophiel's Radiance is a beautiful tool that allows our inner beauty to shine. Use this tool in a trusted company only. Active. Archangel Saurish's Sword of Transmutation is only for very evil energies. This sword is far too powerful to wield lightly, as it is for the worst of the worst. Active, aggressive and passive. Archangel Expedit's Wand of Speed drastically decreases wait time in all situations. This tool is useful on large and small things, one of the only devices that work equally well macro and micro. Active. Archangel Ariel's Wand of Comforts helps you summon any necessity you may have. It is a beautiful and comforting tool when equipped. Active, aggressive and passive. Archangel Israfel's Flaming Sword can protect you against all things directed to you on a macro or micro scale. It can also speed up the time in which something you wish to manifest will come to fruition. Active, aggressive and passive. Archangel Nisarajil's Flaming Sword can bring any negative energy to its knees. It also can remove all obstacles in the way of something you wish to manifest. Passive. Archangel Kamael's Headdress gives you an insight into your inner talents and abilities. Set the intention and use it right before meditation, you will not regret it. Passive. Archangel Raziel's Universal Key allows you access to all wisdom, knowledge, and kingdoms. This key is a beautiful and wild ride that can take you anywhere. Passive. Archangel Lofi's Boutonniere enhances the beauty of yourself and all that you survey. This modality, like all passive tools, must be permitted to work on your behalf. Passive. Archangel Jadutun's Radiant Sounds attract the most beautiful people to your life and enhance your surroundings with beautiful cosmic sounds. It's also a happy enhancer. Passive. Archangel Jephuska's Atmospheric Bracelet brings an element of fun to your nights. Jephuska is the archangel who is in charge of gatherings. If you are so inclined to have one, she would be the recommended party planner. Passive. Archangel Vahumana's Timepiece allows you to savor a positive feeling or thought. It brings an element of majesty to your everyday moments, and it prevents the interference of harmful time travelers. Passive, active and aggressive. Archangel Chamuel's Radiant Peace allows you to be secluded in a peaceful bubble, no matter what is happening around you. This tool also allows those in your heart to have protection as well. Passive and active. Archangel Jeremiel's Enhanced Intuition enables your soul's voices to become louder. It allows the judges of spirit to be more evident than ever. Active. Archangel E's Sword is an omnipotent force of space and time. It can reroute someone's fate without even trying. This sword is a mighty sword that can rewire destiny and remove any obstacle with ease. Active. Kali Ma's trident can handle anything as it is entirely omnipotent. Extremely useful on all things. It is an excellent weapon against electronics and technology, as it can override any circuitry, a perfect tool for any assignment. Aggressive. Archangel Orc's omnipresent shield protects all pure hearts connected to the bearer. It can passively safeguard your loved ones when equipped. This is a contagious shield. Aggressive. Archangel Rigbil's divine teleport moves you to a safer timeline if danger ever arises. You may get disoriented if you shift, but it is guaranteed to be a better timeline than what you were about to experience. Passive and aggressive. Archangel Nail's radiant testing checks the virtues of all beings that you encounter. People who do not have your best interests at heart will make themselves apparent through nervous tics, odd behavior, or random communication. Passive and aggressive. Archangel Pasiginius' vision allows for the full empathy of divinity to penetrate any personal blockages you may have. This tool always shows you the fastest route to safety. Passive. Archangel Asariel's breaker stops all evil plans in their track, regardless of its target. It also enhances your full or new moon intentions that you may have. Passive. Archangel Isle's skyscraper brings celestial energies from the heavens into your micro intentions. This tool can incite miracles. Aggressive. Archangel Asroilu Heavenly Might summons a divine army of experts to your situation, be it good, threatening, or indifferent. If you evoke this tool, things will shape up rapidly. Passive and aggressive. Archangel Kalaziel's radiant rays of health wards off all diseases and illnesses. It can also help recover conditions already inflicted. It works on landmasses and individual living beings. Passive and aggressive. Archangel Thiele's radiant compassion sends heartfelt love to all within your jurisdictions. This tool is the nurturing aspect of healing, and it has incredible warmth. It is best to wield this with a calm frame of mind. Active. Archangel Raphael's healing staff is an omnipotent healing force that works gradually or intensively depending on how you wield it. It is considered the best general healing instrument. Today's assignments. Please use today's current tools if you need assistance performing the tasks below. Nothing is requiring you to do the following. If you are ready, your higher self will call you to duty. If not, skip to the meditation. Please note it is always advised to hold metaphysical modalities for at least a 144 count. You must be ready for unexpected calls to metaphysical action without a prompting. Use the current metaphysical tools. It's go time, you know what to do. Like any great team, we must know that our partners are playing their position properly. The entrance and exit portals here and were enhanced here are still active and running efficiently. Asterisk the Draco Star Race, we spoke of before, has been meddling in humanity for thousands of years. Make it abundantly clear your thoughts of this with Sword and Shield. Asterisk luckily, time travelers have come into this timeline to work malevolently. Now, we can go to many more places and work benevolently. We will be doing this often, so please get comfortable with astral time travel. The Council of Nicer has shaped our world in many ways. Astral travel to the council, announce yourself with Violet Flame, then go in with Sword and Shield. Astral travel to Egypt, to when it was green, tropical and all of the monuments had their original color. Find the land of Punt, the old market west of Egypt, activate the temples in the surrounding area, return to the present time with the knowledge of their location, and then activate it again on our current timeline. The activation codes in lightning form are white, orange, gold, yellow, green, brown, silver, red, platinum, rose gold, diamond, and rainbow. We will see a similar strategy with the Bosnia pyramids astral travel to when they were alive and well. Then, please return to the present time with the knowledge of its operations and activate it again. The activation codes in lightning form are orange, silver, green, pink, orange, indigo, silver, platinum, blue, diamond, and rainbow. Asterisk drown the worries and pains of this world in the following ray lights: white ray, blue ray, yellow ray, pink ray, green ray, ruby ray, violet ray. Asterisk we have a very opportunistic Mandela effect as science discovers that Antarctica's snow contains stardust. It is helpful to evoke the galactic center to spice up our efforts even more. Imbue the Antarctic snow and all snow with the following lights and plasmas. Ray lights, white ray, blue ray, yellow ray, pink ray, green ray, ruby ray, violet ray. Light codes, white, pink, light blue, gold, yellow, green, teal, rose gold, silver, orange, indigo, violet, platinum, diamond, rainbow. Plasma codes, white, pink, light blue, gold, yellow, green, teal, rose gold, silver, orange, indigo, violet, platinum, diamond, rainbow. In a relevant motion, let us imbue all weather patterns in the same way as the stardust travels throughout the world via weather. Ray lights, white ray, blue ray, yellow ray, pink ray, green ray, ruby ray, violet ray. Light codes, white, pink, light blue, gold, yellow, green, teal, rose gold, silver, orange, indigo, violet, platinum, diamond, rainbow. We will go to Limavady, Ireland, and its ancient temple. It would be best to administer heavy violet flame in this area from its ancient inception to our current time. Asterisk areas in need of a violet flame bath: Dublin, Strasbourg, France, Johannesburg, North Sweden, Myanmar, Winnipeg, Odessa, Ukraine, Melbourne, Sydney, Perth, Lagos, Cairo, Kumasi, Luanda, Benin City, NYC, Los Angeles, Washington, D.C., Denver, Toronto, Nashville, Miami, and Dallas. Asterisk alignment seems to be the theme of the universe. All of the planets in our solar system are imbued and optimized. Now, let's envision the following lights from the heart of the galaxy traveling through Saturn to our Moon, back to Jupiter, and then engulfing the Earth. Light codes, white, pink, light blue, gold, yellow, green, red, black, brown, teal, rose gold, silver, orange, indigo, violet, platinum, diamond, rainbow. Asterisk places to send a stairway to heaven: Limavady in Dublin, Ireland, Oslo, Mexico City, Madagascar, Melbourne, Sydney, Perth, Monrovia, Hanoi, Bali, Tokyo, Beijing, Aleppo, Nashville, Greenland, Antarctica, and Los Angeles. Asterisk the temple is known as Somavati Stupa in Sri Lanka, is the oldest stargate on Earth. Activate this ancient technology with the following lightning burst sent throughout the circumference of the stargate. This section of land is traditionally considered the most galactic active area on Earth. Electric pulses, white, pink, light blue, gold, yellow, green, red, black, brown, teal, rose gold, silver, orange, indigo, violet, platinum, diamond, rainbow. Asterisk we will give the Earth intense love, and it will inspire many different expressions. Charge the Earth's center with the following plasmas: white, pink, light blue, gold, yellow, green, red, black, brown, teal, rose gold, silver, orange, indigo, violet, platinum, diamond, rainbow. Asterisk it is a good general practice to leave the entirety of the Earth in divine orchestration as we finish up our work. Engulf the Earth in the following flames: white, pink, light blue, gold, yellow, green, red, teal, rose gold, silver, orange, indigo, violet, platinum, diamond, rainbow. Engulf the Earth in the following lights: white, pink, light blue, gold, yellow, green, red, teal, rose gold, silver, orange, indigo, violet, platinum, diamond, rainbow. Engulf the Earth with the following ray lights: white ray, blue ray, yellow ray, pink ray, green ray, ruby ray, violet ray. Please join us in our cold full moon puja. It is available at archangelickcalendar.com. Today's mediation is above. Please enjoy.